Tonight about whether the check or anything else will be in the mail. Postal workers today rallied all over the tri-state to save their jobs. News 5's Terry Daniels has the story.
A lot of my stuff is emailed these days.
Sarah Gossett doesn't use the mail as often as she used to, but her company does. She drops off lots of letters and packages here at the main post office.
It's much cheaper to send things through the post office than UPS and FedEx, and it would probably triple prices, at least for the company I work for.
And that's part of the reason these postal workers say they rallied around the country today, including down on Fountain Square. They say home and business delivery would suffer and thousands of workers would lose their jobs, all because of a mandate passed by Congress in 2006.
The Postal Service is the only government agency or only private company in the country that has to pre-fund the retirees' health care for 75 years.
It's $5.5 billion a year that the Postal Service is required to pay. In other words, it'd be like if you or I, if we had a 75-year mortgage on our home, that we'd be required to pay it down in 10 years.
The answer, they say, is House Bill 1351. Supporters included Democratic Mayor Mark Mallory and Republican Council Member Charlie Winburn.
It is the right thing to do. It's more important to do the right thing to be a member of a party. And the right thing to do is to support all of these individuals that may lose their jobs.
Yes, 1351!
And if 1351 is passed, these workers believe the mail will continue to be delivered on time.
Terry Daniels reporting, the people those postal workers really have to persuade are members of Congress. We'll keep following the progress of that bill.